went on the cross of Calvary. The Lord was crucified. The mob stood round about him, and they mocked him until he died. And there were two thieves hanging there beside him, just to share the agony. But one of them cried out to him, "Oh Lord, remember me." Oh, 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 what a shame to kill him out there on that old rugged cross. But such a death was needed just to rescue all of us that was lost. Oh, his blood is made of ransom just to set the captive free. I know that I'm included. Hey, I know God will remember me. Oh,
be seated. Yes, perfect. Welcome to Knoxville National. My name is James and I'm a cemetery representative, and we're here to pay our respects today for one of our nation's heroes, Mr. Alfred Smith. He served his country with honor and with dignity, and he has earned his military rights, and we're going to provide that for him today. If you have cell phones, will you please put your cell phones on silent? We don't want to interrupt the military honors, neither the chaplain. If you want to take pictures with your cell phone, you may. And if you want to record with your cell phone, you may. But if you're not, please put your cell phone on silent. We don't want to interrupt anyone. At this time, I will turn it over to the military, and then I thank the chaplain. Will.
Man that is born of a woman hath but a short time to live, and is cut down like a flower. He fleeth as it were a shadow, and never continueth in one stay. In the midst of life, we are in death. Whom may we seek for secure but of thee, O Lord, who for our sins are justly displeased? Yet, O Lord God, most holy, O Lord most mighty, O holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us not into the bitter pains of eternal death. Thou knowest, Lord, the secrets of our hearts. Shut not thy merciful ears to our prayer. O Lord, most holy God, most mighty, O holy and merciful Savior, thou most worthily judge eternal. Suffer us not in our last hour for any pains of death to fall into. For as much as it pleases Almighty God in His wise providence to bring out the world to those of His heart, we therefore commit His body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection in the last day and the life of the world to come, through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose second coming in glorious majesty to judge the world. The earth and sea shall give up their dead, and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in Him shall be changed, made alike unto His own glorious body, according to the mighty working whereby He's able to subdue all things unto Himself. I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, from henceforth, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Even so saith the Spirit, for they rest from their labors. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. O merciful God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, and whom whosoever believeth shall live though he die, whosoever liveth and believeth in Him shall not die eternally. We meekly beseech Thee, O Father, to raise us from the dead of sin to life, and that when we shall depart this life, we may rest in him, and at the general resurrection, at the last day, may be found acceptable in his sight, and receive the blessing which thy well-beloved Son shall then pronounce to all them that love and fear thee, saying, Come, ye blessed children of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Grant this, we beseech thee, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our mediator and redeemer. Amen. Would you pray with me the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples to pray, the Lord's Prayer? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. Now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet communion of his Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide with you henceforth, now and forevermore. Let us all say, Amen. Now we'll turn it over to the minister.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Chaplain Emmy with the Volunteer State Honor Guard, and on behalf of the Honor Guard that stands before you today, the military of our country, and a grateful nation, we offer our condolences to the family and friends gathered here today in this difficult time in your life. The Honor Guard has come before you today to celebrate and honor the life of Tech Sergeant Alfred Smith, retired United States Air Force, and to render military honor for his service and dedication to our country. We were not privileged to know Sergeant Smith personally. However, when we see the flag of our nation here, this tells us much about this man. But here was a man who loved liberty, justice, and freedom. When his country needed him, he answered the call. He went where he was asked to go, did what he was asked to do without any assurance whatsoever that he would ever return to family, friends, job, or the life that he had known before. We owe Sergeant Smith a great debt of gratitude for his love, service, and dedication to our country. For truly, here was a man who loved freedom. And you know, we hear a lot of talk about freedom in our country today, folks, but I must remind everyone assembled here today that freedom is not free. It has been bought and paid for with a horrible price, with the lives, blood, and wounds of some of America's finest. Since the birth of our nation, over 1,220,000 of our finest have given their lives so that you and I may enjoy the rights, privileges, and freedoms that we have in our country today. In addition, though, to those who paid the ultimate sacrifice for our freedom, another 1,530,000 plus have been wounded and have or will carry their stories today. Freedom is not free, folks, and I pray that we never take it for granted, as we all sometimes do. But we live in the greatest nation on the face of the country. Not threatened by any means, our country has many problems to many people. But thanks to the service and dedication of the men and women like Alfred Smith, we're free. We're free to assemble here today and pay our respects. We're free to work. We're free to play. And number one, we're free to worship God in any manner we see fit without fear. And these are all rights and privileges that have been maintained for us by the 40 million men and women who have put on the uniform of the Armed Forces of the United States. I'm also reminded today, though, folks, of another freedom that we enjoy that was purchased in blood. The blood of God's only Son, Jesus, on Calvary's cross so that we might have the greatest freedom, the freedom from sin. In a moment, you will hear the highest honors the military can provide to a fallen veteran, that of the rifle salute. It is a time-honored tradition that comes to us from before the days of Jesus to the times of the early Greek and Roman Empire. When one of their soldiers would fall, three of his comrades would go by the open grave, scoop up a handful of dirt, cast it in and call out that man's name loudly three times to say farewell. Today it comes to us in the form of a rifle salute. There'll be three volleys and I'll caution you the first one that's going to allow us to fall. And then in the distance we will hear taps. Taps is played at the end of the day on every United States military installation in the world. And what it tells our soldiers, sailors, airmen, and Marines is that the day's work is done. It's time to rest. We feel that it's only fitting that we hear it here today. For Sergeant Alfred Smith's work here is done, it's time for him to take his eternal rest. And if I could speak to Sergeant Smith today, I would say, beloved, you have finished the course. Your battles have all been fought. And as we lay your body to rest in peace, may your life and your good deeds be remembered always. Today, we honor you. May we pray. We thank you, Almighty God, our Father, and we thank you, sweet Lord Jesus, our Savior and Redeemer, for the privilege of assembling here today and paying our respects to Alfred Smith. My Father, my Savior, I lift this family up to you. Place them tight against your bosom and be with them in these difficult times. Lord, bless this family in all means, at all times, and all ways. I also ask, Lord, that you bless our troops, no matter where they may be stationed. We even now, Lord, the gates of freedom, so that we may have the freedom and rights that we have in our country today. My Father and my Savior, go with this family. Comfort them, strengthen them, show them your tender mercy, Lord. Bless them in all ways in this time. And I ask that you place a hedge of protection around each and every one gathered here today, Lord, not only in their travels, but in their lives. We thank you so much, our Father and our Savior, for life, for love, for liberty, and for the life, for the life of Alfred Smith. Lord, be with this family and bless them in all ways. For it's in your precious, holy, and beautiful name, our Savior and Redeemer Jesus, that we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Prepare yourself for firing.
Volunteer State Veterans Honor Corps, it has been a privilege and an honor to serve your family here today. So sorry for your loss. Thank you, and may God bless each and every one here.
The Dorican and Sun March, where we'd like to thank this family again for letting us host the celebration of your loved one. We will continue to remember you in our prayers. Thank you.
Does conclude the short military committal. Mr. Smith, I had spoke to the sister there. I gave her a packet with the grave number. It's kind of right up here on top of this hill. It's 216. Of course, you'll see it because it will have a temporary marker with his name on it. And then we're going to order him a headstone here. So, but we just ask that you not visit the grave site for about 30 minutes, please. Let the caretakers lay him to rest because it's a safety hazard. So if you give us about 30 minutes, then you may visit the gravesite. You're dismissed.
Oh! Thank you, Jesus.